You have joined me in another episode of the Curtis Zone, and I thank you for that. I, of course, am your humble and handsome host, Dylan J. Curtis, and we are giving you guys another episode, another history of episode. I know, I messed up there, I'm sorry. Today is a history on a show that you may not know called Kamen Rider Dragon Knight. Sit back, relax, enjoy, and of course remember to hit the like and subscribe button for more content from the Curtis Zone. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, or if you just want to make a request for a history of episode, leave it in the comment section located down there. And as always, enjoy. Now you know I can't give you a history of episode or any episode really without giving you guys a little bit of news. And here's some news for you right now. It has been officially announced that Jamie Foxx will be taking over the reins of Michael Jai White's former character, Spawn, which means that Warner Brothers will be going forward with a Spawn live-action movie. It is set to hit theaters late 2023 or early 2024. I personally am excited for it, and I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm kind of wondering how Jamie Foxx does it. Another piece of news from Marvel. They have officially finished filming and they're currently in post-production for the new MCU Blade film, which means that they're currently in talks for a new MCU movie, which is also supposed to have Blade, Moon Knight, Ghost Rider, Punisher, and Doctor Strange, called The Midnight Suns. That it is set to hit theaters mid to late 2024. But it is said to be equally as awesome as both Doctor Strange films. Meaning that we're gonna have some frightening images, a lot to go on, guys. The final piece of news I'm gonna leave you guys is the fact that Steve Cardenas, David Yost, Walter Jones, and Catherine Sutherland have all joined the ranks to be in the 30th anniversary of Power Rangers for Power Rangers Cosmic Fury. This episode is set to be a 1-hour episode, and I'm gonna be honest with you, I kinda can't wait to see it. The only holdout is the fact that Jason David Frank has not said yes. Amy Jo Johnson has retired because she has retired from the role of Power Rangers because she is pursuing another project. And Austin St. John is still going through some legal troubles. But it is said that this will be equally as fun as every previous team-up of Power Rangers. I personally can't wait for it. And we are also currently waiting for Power Rangers Quantum Continuum, which is being written by David Yost. He has said that it is going to be a combination of Star Trek meets Once Upon a Time meets Power Rangers. I can't wait, you can't wait, let's wait, guys. But for now, let's get into Kamen Rider Dragon Knight. Remember, like and subscribe for more content from the Curtis Zone. Kamen Rider Dragon Knight would have its television debut in December of 2008 and would have its final episode in exactly 1 year after its premiere. It premiered on the CW for Kids and would be continued to go on YouTube.
Now, before I can tell you guys about the events that happened in the first episode, we need to go back before the first episode, because that is the true fictional origin of Kamen Rider Dragon Knight.
In the first episode, we meet Yubilon, who is from a race known as the Karsh. He comes to Ventar because his top general, known as Xaviax, has waged war against it. And so he comes to Ventar to create the Kamen Riders, which is a group of highly trained, skilled, professional fighters who defend Ventara from Xaviax no matter what. However, Xaviax manages to convince Adam, who is the original Kamen Rider Dragon Knight, to betray his fellow riders, and Xaviax manages to vent them all in their sleep. He then takes all their decks from all of them. What is vented, you may ask? When a rider loses too much power, they are sent to the Advent Void after being vented, meaning that they disintegrate and go to the void, and then they can recharge and replenish their power. However, the only person who has the key to the Advent Void is Master Yubilon, the Advent Master, and without him, people were just stuck inside the void. Xaviax vented all the riders and stole the Advent Dex because he found a new planet, a planet called Earth, and everyone on Earth has a twin from Ventara, even the Kamen Riders.
Now this leads us to the events of the first episode when we meet young Kit Taylor. Now I wouldn't say that he was a bad kid, he's just that kid that gets caught doing the wrong thing at the wrong time. Okay, like a lot of bad boy characters. One thing I should mention, guys, every Kamen Rider, every character in this show, they drive a motorcycle. Even Kit Taylor. Now, in the events that happened in the first episode, Kit Taylor finds the Dragon Deck. Now, I'm going to explain to you about what the Dragon Deck is in powers and abilities. But the Dragon Deck gives him the ability to contract with a dragon. This is until we meet Lin.
Now, the one thing you need to know about Kit is that he's haunted by the memory of his missing father, who we later found out was made sick by Xaviax. And then we also meet Maya, who is a reporter and who later becomes Kamen Rider Siren after Case gets vented.
In the first episode, Maya is accidentally stumbles into the world behind Ventara and becomes a new resident of it. And Lin helps her out as well as Kit. In the first episode, Lin helps Kit escape Ventara while at the same time escaping his advent beast, the dragon. However, this didn't last long as Kit used the contract card to become the new Kamen Rider Dragonite. When you use the contract card, you're in it for life, my friend.
Now, with all that said, let's talk about important moments within the series, shall we? The first important moment that you need to know about in the series is the fact that Xaviax has to find the riders who are exact twins of riders from Ventara, okay? This means that every rider on Ventara has a twin from Earth that lives on Earth, all right? And he basically makes him a deal in exchange for venting Wing Knight. See, Wing Knight was the only person that escaped Xaviax, which means that, you know what? Let's not move on to that. I'm not going to spoil the whole thing for you, all right? You watch the series. Another important moment in the series is when Adam, Kit's twin from Ventara, basically comes back because he wants to work for, he doesn't want to work for Xaviax, but Xaviax has made him a promise that in exchange for his help, in exchange for infiltrating Master Yubulon and getting all the information on the riders, he gets to work, he and Sarah get to stay in Ventara. All right, I know guys, I'm stuttering, but just bear with me here. Now, the final important thing that you need to know about the series is the fact that Master Yubulon, he assigned the decks, which means he can also reassign the decks, which is why he gave Maya Case's old deck, the deck of Kamen Rider Siren. It was pretty cool, guys. Pretty important moment. And now, let's talk about my top five favorite moments within the series, shall we?
You ready? I only have three favorite moments, and one of those is back in black. You see, Kit was originally vented as Dragon Knight, but he comes back as the Black Dragon Knight or Kamen Rider Onyx. This is after we found out that he had nightmares about the Black Dragon Knight, but it turned out to be the rage of the Advent Beast. But now that he's contracted with the Beast is tamed. My second favorite moment is the power of the Survive Mode cards. Even though they didn't last long, Lin and Kit used them to not only vent Kamen Rider Strike, but to vent Kamen Rider Wrath as well, while Xaviax had taken over his body. See, I like the Survive Mode cards because not only did they change their armor, it also changed their weapons and powers as well. And it also changed their Advent Beast, turning them into basically giant motorcycles. My final favorite moment is in the last episode, when Xaviax goes up against Master Yubulon. And while the Kamen Rider is distracting him, Master Yubulon opens the Advent Void and brings in all the other riders that have been in there. And all of them use the Link Vent in order to finally destroy him.
And now, let's move on to powers and abilities, shall we?
The Kamen Rider is linked with these Advent Beasts, which are basically monsters that are similar to Earth's Animal Kingdom, which gives them amazing vehicles and fighting skills. This gives them amazing weapons and or skills like swords, axes, spears, you name it. But the most powerful weapon is their final vent. My favorite is Kamen Rider Torx because he is all about guns. They also have amazing cards that have different types of abilities like steel vent, copy vent, confined vent, you name it. And all in all, the Kamen Riders are basically the most powerful or equivalent to the Power Rangers. Not just in power, but in skill as well. Now, the one thing that you should know is that one rider can use one set of cards that is specific to them. No rider can use someone else's cards. All in all, these guys are pretty cool. That's why I love this show.
Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of The Curtis Zone. I, of course, your humble and handsome host, Dylan J. Curtis. Thank you for joining us. And remember to hit the like and subscribe button for more content from The Curtis Zone. Or if you want, you can just leave a comment in the section located that way if you want to make a request for a history of episode. And of course, remember, I'm always here, no matter what.
So hard, it seems like he's never got time because he writes every note and he writes every line. And I-